Welcome to Not the Lights Over Arkham. I'm JP, and we're continuing Calvin Wright's run through the Circle London. This time we'll be playing the scenario for the greater good. So, the last scenarios haven't gone really well for Calvin. First we got defeated in the secret name, and after that we also got defeated in the Wages of Sin, and we didn't get any heretics defeated in that one. We managed to get 1 XP so that I could upgrade Miss Doyle into the deck, so let's quickly check the deck. So I added Miss Doyle because Miss Doyle and her cat army works really well in Calvin, because you will add the skill value and all the damage and horror on Calvin, so that, for example, if you're fighting and you have the right cat out, you're fighting with base skill of 5 plus the damage on you and etc. To fit Miss Doyle into the deck, we had to remove one of the Peter Sylvestres, but I haven't had Peter in play that much either way, so I hope that's fine. I didn't really find any other cards to cut for Miss Doyle. But that's enough of the deck. The deck didn't change that much from the last scenario. So let's see the setup for the scenario. Because Calvin is enemy of the lodge, we have the membership only locations of the lodge gates, lodge cellar and lobby in play. So we have to sneak into the Silver Twilight Lodge and try to find out some more information about the strange happenings in Arkham. Other than that, let's just hope we can finally get a win out of a scenario with Calvin. So let's get started.
If you like my content, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss anything.
I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. We get 5 of Pentacles, Run for Your Life, Sharp Vision, Leather Coat, and Trial by Fire. We will, of course, keep the 5 of Pentacles. The other cards, I think, I'll just mulligan the rest and try to get some weapons and stuff. Well, we get the second 5 of Pentacles. So I think how this works, I can choose not to play this. So, well, it doesn't do anything, but let's just keep it if we have to discard a random card or something. We get a Reckless Assault, Fire Axe, and a Ward of Protection. So I think that's a okay hand to start with. We have something to fight with, and we already have a sanity of 3, so we have a decent way to investigate. So let's shuffle these cards back into the deck. So the objective is to find these keys. We have a Skull Key, a Cultist Key, a Tablet Key, and an Elder Key. Different triggers will put these keys into play, and we can collect them. And they unlock different areas. So, for example, we can't go into the Lodge Catacombs before we have at least one of the keys. And other than that, we try to avoid the Lodge Cultists. So, because we're enemies of the Lodge, we don't have the Silver Twilight enemies, but we have the Cultist enemies from the core set in the encounter deck, so we probably have to fight them. Fight them to get somewhere in this scenario. Okay. First action, I'll play down the Pyrex. Second action, There's nothing else to play at the moment. We'll investigate. So I'm investigating 3 versus 2. Oh yeah, and we can't move here before we have spent one clues as a group so that we can reveal this. So that's basically that we're trying to sneak in. So we're finding the way into the cellar out of hell. And let's investigate again. So not a good start for the token pools, but let's see how this continues. The second one is a skull. Skull is X, where X is the highest number of two monocultist enemy. So it's 0. So we get this clue and we can get into the cellar next turn. So that is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw one card. We get a lucky and we gain one resource. Okay, so that's the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add one doom, so the threshold is 8, so we're 1 of 8 doom. And of course I forgot to mention that we have the forced effect. When you defeat a silver twilight enemy, you leave behind some evidence of the scuffle. Move one doom from the enemy at that location to current agenda. Noteworthy is that the core set cultists are not, as I recall, silver twilight enemies, so that doesn't apply to them, but there are other enemies that have the silver twilight trait. Oh yeah, and we need two clues to advance, and after you evade an enemy, remove all doom from it. So there's that. Okay, so let's take the counter card, and it is Mysteries of the Lodge. Place one doom on the nearest cultist enemy, then until the end of the round, increase the difficulty to fight, evade, and or parley with that enemy by 2. If no doom is placed by this effect, Mysteries Lodge gets searched, so we search it. We get beneath the lodge. If you control at least one of the keys, beneath the lodge gains peril and is killed as plus 1 difficulty. So we test book 3. For each point you fail by, you must either lose one clue or take one horror. So we definitely can't lose the clue, because we would be stuck. So we have to take the horror. Let's see how it goes. I'm not committing anything to this test, so we get the Elder thing. It's a minus 3. So I will play lucky. I only fail by 1, so I'll take 1 horror. That's fine, because now we have a better investigate value. And that's resolved. So, first action. We'll use this ability here to access the cellar. So this gets revealed. There's no clues there. Second action. We move here, and third action will just move here. But we move into the lobby because that way is blocked right now. There's one clue at the lobby. Forced after the lobby is revealed, place one random set aside key on it. So usually I just shuffle these in my hand and drop one at random. So we have the skull key on the lobby. And I think that is our turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. I draw one card and it's the hiding spot, and we gain one resource. And that is our turn. And let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, and the encounter card for this turn is Expulsion. If there are no cultist enemies in play, Expulsion gets searched. We get an Ancient Evil, so we add one clue to the agenda. And that's it. Oh yeah, and if there are no clues on a location, we can then pick up the key as a pre-triggered ability. So this turn I think I will just try to investigate here, so we can grab this key. So I'm investigating 4 versus 3. It's a 0. We grab this clue. Oh yeah, and we had to spend this clue, which I forgot to do earlier. And we can now gain control of this key. Second action, I will move to the lounge. Lounge has 2 clues per investigator. Forced ability, after the lounge is revealed, put the set aside vault and library locations into play. Put the set aside August linguist asset into play and lounge. Place 1 random set aside key on him. Okay, so we add August linguist here. And also the library and the vault. And we place 1 random key on August linguist. And it's the elder thing sign. And that's actually quite lucky, because we can't move into the vault if we don't have the elder thing. So I think we need to get some clues and parlay with the August linguist to get that key off of him. So yeah, I think that was my second action to move there. Third action, I will investigate here. I'm investigating 4 versus 2. So I need a minus 2 or better. And it's a minus 2. So we get 1 clue. And next turn we can parlay with August Linguist, or we could also advance, but I think we need the key from him. No enemies, so we go to upkeep. We get another reward of protection, and we gain 1 resource. And that is our turn, so let's continue to the next turn. We add another threat, so we are at 4 of 8. Doom, I'll actually move this guy here, because he was out of frame. This a bit down. We get an encounter card, and it is a cellar keeper, spawn any sanctum location alert. And it's a humanoid cultist silver twilight enemy. Forced, after cellar keeper enters place, we place 2 doom and 1 random set aside key on it. When you evade cell keeper by 2 or more, take control of its key. So he has the cultist key, and we place 2 doom on him. And also, cellar keeper is in the only sanctum location, that is the lodge catacombs. Let's see here. First action, I will parlay, so I gain control of this. So each investigator who spent at least 1 clue must either take 1 damage or 1 horror. I'll opt to take the damage, so I get my fight skill up. And remove August Linguist from the game and take control of his key. So we got the second key. Second action, I will investigate here. And it's an auto fail. I'll just investigate again. I think next turn we'll move into the vault either way, so just try to grab this clue here. So 4 versus 2, it's an elder sign, so I think I'm fine with the damage and horror at the moment, so I'm not taking any more, but I'll still grab this clue. And that is our turn. Enemy phase, this guy doesn't have a hunter, so he doesn't do anything. We get the card, and we gain one resource. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, so we are now at 5, 6, 7 of 8 doom. If we hit an ancient evils, would be quite bad. So we get a wizard of the order. He spawns at any empty location. I think we put him into the vault, because we can go there in there and kill him. And he doesn't have the silver twilight key trait, so that's fine. Okay, so that's the metaspace done. First action, I'll move into the vault, because I have the Elder Thing key. The vault is a four shroud location. There's one clue. After the vault is revealed, place one random set aside key on it, and there's only one key left, so put it there. Okay, so we're getting the keys quite fast this time, playing this scenario. I have had some trouble a few times getting hold of these keys. So this guy engages us, second action. We will fight this guy. I'll use three resources. So I'm fighting three plus six, so nine versus four. So minus five or better. It's a skull, and it's a minus two, but we still do one damage. And second action, I will, let's see. Yeah, I don't really have the many good assets to use the resources on at the moment, so I'll just pay three resources to boost this again by three. Six. So nine versus four, so minus five or better. And it's a minus two. So we defeat this guy. Oh yeah, and at the end of the mythos phase we would have added a doom on him, but that doesn't matter. So this guy gets defeated. And that's it. Enemy phase, nothing happens. And we go to upkeep, so we draw one card. We gain Peter Silvestre, finally, an ally. I would rather see my Miss Doyle or Yatol at this moment, but it's fine. And we gain a resource, so that is that. And let's go to the next turn. So we add the 8th doom, and the agenda advances. So meeting of minds, there is a meeting that we happen to hear. They're talking about this ritual or some kind of box that will capture maybe the spectral watcher, but a lot of fluff text that I won't be reading. So we discard the five cards, and if we hit the enemy, we draw it. Okay, so we hit one cultist. So it's the Knight of the Inner Circle. Spawn any location connected to yours. Pray most keys controlled. Alert, aloof, hunter. After you enter the Knight of the Inner Circle's location, or vice versa, test agility 4. If you fail, Knight of the Order engages you. So he could sneak past him, but it's quite possible that he will engage us. But we can also try to evade him and run away. And now we have a doom threshold of 10, and that's the last agenda. And we can get an encounter card, and it's an ancient evils. Actually, I will slow the game down, and I'll take one more horror, and I'll use the Ward of Protection to cancel that ancient evils. We don't want to lose any turns at this point. Okay, so first action. Let's see. The guy just need to try and investigate. So I am investigating 4 versus... I mean 5 versus 4. I don't have any good cards to boost this, so I'll just try. And it's a minus 2. We try again. Minus 4, and let's try one more time. And it's 0, because now there's no clue on anything. So we grab this clue. We gain this key, and now we can also advance. So we advance. If the Inner Sanctum is not in play, put it into play. We put the Inner Sanctum into play, and it's connected to the Lodge Catacombs. And we need actually the key that guy has to enter that. Spawn the set aside Nathan Vic enemy into the Inner Sanctum. And we spawn him Master of Introduction. Indoctrination side face up, and we attach the puzzle box on him. So that guy is there. So I think we need to go get that puzzle box. For the remainder of the game, the current acts gain first triggered ability. After you evade an enemy, remove all doom from it. Place this card next to the deck. Remind. Let's put it here. That is our turn. We need to put some tokens on this guy. So we spawned him here. So he moves here. We test the agility. Actually, before that guy moves, I will play hiding spot as a fast action. Oh yeah, that doesn't help because the guy is already aloof, so I think I'll just use that for the skill test. So we are trying to test against we're testing 5 versus 4, so minus 1 or better. Minus 2, so this guy engages us, and he hits us, so we take 2 damage. Okay, so that's the enemy phase. We go to upkeep, we draw 1 card, and we gain 1 resource. Okay. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card is another Knight of the Inner Circle. Well, this isn't really nice. Okay, we're in a bit of a trouble with these Knights of the Inner Circle. First action, I'll try to evade this knight. It's a minus 3, but we're agility 5, so we managed to evade. Second action, we'll move here. This guy, we will test 5 versus 4. It's a 0, so we don't get engaged. And last action, we'll move here. We need to get into the cellar. So that is our turn. Enemy phase, this guy moves here, and we have to test again. I think I will just try... He engages us, we're dead. That's not good. So I actually have to try to pass this test. So I'll commit those cards. That was stupid miss from my part. I should have engaged and evaded that guy. Okay, so let's see what we do. So it's a skull. It's a zero. So luckily we don't get engaged with that guy. Okay, and enemy phase that done. We go to upkeep. This guy readies. We gain one resource and draw one card. Another fire axe. So that is our turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom and the encounter card is an acolyte. Okay, I have to think a bit where we want to put that guy. So, I think I don't have time to go into the library to get the victory point from there. So, just put this guy there and we just forget about him. And that is the Mythos phase. First action, I'll use three resources to lay down Peter Sylvester. And I'll move. And I'll move again. Now I have a key, so I can enter here. So when Lodge Catacombs is revealed, put the set aside Inner Sanctum and each of the other set aside Sanctum doorways. Okay, so this Inner Sanctum is already in play, so we actually will add these locations over here. And this guy engages us. And then this guy moves here, and this guy moves here. Okay. And this guy hits us, so we take two horror. I put one on Peter, and one on myself. And that is the enemy phase. We go to upkeep. We draw a card, we gain the run for your life. That's really good when we need to evade Nathan Vick. And we gain one resource. And that is our turn. So let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. So we are at 4 of 10 doom. And we get another acolyte. And now the vault is an empty location, so we just add that acolyte there. And I'm running out of monster management tokens, so I'll just use these. We basically just have to ignore those. We don't have time to resolve them. I think we will evade this cell keeper. I'm evading 5 versus 2. It's a minus 3, so when this guy is evaded, we take control of his key. So now we have all of the keys. Now we can move into the Inner Sanctum. And we would place one set aside key on it, but they are all in play. And this guy engages us. And just double check this. So after you evade Nathan Vick by 3 or more, you steal the puzzle box, add Nathan Vick to the victory display. So last action, you will evade and I will use the run for your life. So I am evading 10 versus 3. And it's a minus 3. So I pass by 3 or more, so we gain control of the puzzle box. And also Nathan Vick goes into victory display. Just put it over here. And that is our turn. Also, if Nathan Vick is added to the victory display by any means, choose an investigator to take control of the attached puzzle box and advance. So we advance, so we evaded Nathan Vick. So we basically steal the device up of him. And we are gone before he notices anything. Then, the four keys. If investigators at the same location control the puzzle box, the skull key, the cultist key, and the tablet key, and the elder thing key advance. So we get to advance right now. Okay, so we managed to beat the scenario quite easily. Phew, well, there was one close moment, but let's see. So, if the investigators are members of the lodge, resolution 1, otherwise, resolution 2. Okay, so, resolution 2, let's see. So, we record in our campaign log. The investigator discovered how to open the puzzle box. Any one investigator may choose to add the puzzle box story asset to his or her deck. So I will be adding it to Calvin's deck. This card does not count towards the investigator's deck size. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. So we have the vault, which is one victory point location, and we have an 8 and Vic that is one victory point. So we get two victory points. That's actually enough, because next time we won't be going into the Union and Disillusion, but because I got the new blob that ate everything side scenario, so I think I will be trying that out with Calvin. So next time we will be trying to stop the blob from eating everything. So thanks for watching, and until next time.